Hey, how's it going, everybody? Welcome back to Art of Creation Homestead. We're out here. It's a beautiful Sunday afternoon. And again, we're going to talk about Jesus today. We always do a weekly devotional. And if some of you know, I've been going through the book of John. So last week, we started John chapter 6, where Jesus had fed the 5,000. And we'll pick it back up here just after that in John chapter 6 and verse 14. So we'll say John 6, 14 says, after the people saw the miraculous sign that Jesus did, they began to say, surely this is the prophet who is to come into the world. Jesus, knowing that they intended to come and make him king by force, withdrew again to a mountain by himself. When evening came, his disciples went down to the lake, where they got into a boat and set off across the lake for Capernaum. By now it was dark, and Jesus had not yet joined them. A strong wind was blowing, and the waters grew rough. When they had rowed three or three and a half miles, they saw Jesus approaching the boat, walking on the water, and they were terrified. But he said to them, it is I, don't be afraid. Then they were willing to take him into the boat, and immediately the boat reached the shore where they were heading. So a lot of fascinating things in that short piece there. And it may just sound like, hey, you know, Jesus left that scene, you know, walked out into the water and said, hey, don't worry, it's me, and, you know, to get where they were trying to go. I see some different things in there. First of all, it says Jesus, knowing they intended to make him king by force, withdrew. Okay, so he ran away. The Israelites, the Jews, had this thing where they thought that Messiah was going to come and overthrow the Roman Empire. He was going to overthrow their current government, and they were going to dominate, and they were going to, you know, run the world. That's not exactly how it goes. But after that, his disciples went down to the lake, they got in a boat, and they started rowing. And now again, you know, if you've been watching my devotionals, you know what I've said about the book of John, and how I love how John wrote, and how he's a creative writer, how he wrote some things in there for a purpose that you may take some, like, thinking about and some figuring on, but it's great analogies. Darkness and light. Light and darkness was a big, big, big thing for him throughout this entire Bible, or throughout this entire book, and 1st, 2nd, 3rd John as well. Okay. This right here it's a good one. It says, where they got into a boat and set off across the lake for Capernaum, by now it was dark. By now it was dark, and Jesus wasn't with them. Okay, Jesus hadn't joined them. So when they're out there, it says a strong wind was blowing. You know, the waters are getting rough. They were 3 and 3.5 miles out. They've been battling this storm, right? For 3 and 3.5 miles. I don't know if I could row a boat for 3 and 3.5 miles, okay? Out into the lake in a storm, right? So they had to be getting exhausted. They were getting wore out and probably really frustrated. Yeah, I can imagine they were slapping each other in the back of the head, getting mad at each other. Hey, do this, you know, bossing each other around. You know, Peter and John were probably arguing like crazy since they were competing with each other all the time. It just had to be a mess inside that dang boat, right? I couldn't imagine, you know, 12 people trying to get along on a rough lake in a storm trying to row a dang boat. These guys, it was a disaster. They were probably arguing junk. But anyway, so they were out there, and then they saw Jesus approaching. They were afraid. Naturally, you see a dude walking in the middle of the dang lake. Sheesh. Obviously, they were afraid, right? Wait a second. They were tired. They were exhausted, frustrated. Now see a figure of a person walking on a lake. Yeah, okay, it's going to probably freak you out. They said to him, hey, it's I. Don't be afraid. And they knew. And they knew then. Says, okay, they were willing to take him in the boat. And immediately, the boat reached the shore where they were heading. You know, a lot of times in life, we go through some hard things. Even as a disciple of Jesus, as a follower of Jesus, as somebody who trusts in God, it ain't gonna be easy all the time. Nowhere did it ever say that after you become a Christian, after you get a relationship with Jesus, that everything's gonna be easy. That's false. If anybody leads you to believe that, they're lying, okay? They're ignorant, they're lying, they're trying to deceive you, trying to exploit you, whatever. But it's a dang lie, plain and simple, okay? It's not easy. Life ain't easy in general. It may be easier to some extent with Jesus because you have a hope, you have somebody you can trust in, you have somebody to get you through these things. It's hard no matter what though, right? It's hard no matter what. And you're going to face battles. You're going to face trials. You're going to feel like you've been rowing a boat 3 to 3.5 miles out in the middle of a stormy lake, and that there ain't nobody there to help you. You're going to have those times. But Jesus was there to help you navigate through those things. And that's what he did for the disciples. It was dark. It was dark. We face dark times. We face hard times. We face times where we feel like, hey, Jesus ain't there. It's dark. I'm doing this all by myself. I'm alone. And you're not going to have a good, you're not always going to have a good attitude about it. You're not always going to be easy to get along with. And you're going to get frustrated. You're going to be tired. But Jesus is always there to help you navigate through that darkness, same as he did with his disciples. They were out there and they were trying to row this boat and try to get to the next stop, right? They're just trying to get to the destination. And it was tough. But Jesus helped them navigate through that darkness and they got there. God's always going to help you navigate through the darkness. Always. You're going to, just because Jesus is light, just because he's the light of the world, doesn't mean that you are not going to go through darkness. But he's always going to be there to help you navigate through that darkness. So it's very simple, but that's all there is to it. Jesus is going to help you navigate through that darkness. Don't give up. Keep rowing, keep battling, keep fighting. Yes, you'll be tired. Yes, you'll be frustrated. Yes, you're going to feel alone. Yes, these are very real things, but Jesus is there to help you navigate through those problems and help you get to the other side. All right. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you have comments, prayer requests, praise reports, please leave them below. I'd love to hear from you. My name is Jason. This is our Creation Homestead. I love y'all. God bless you and goodbye.